Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn AE tips, tricks, and shortcuts in less than 7 minutes. No BS, just AE. In this episode, I'll show you how to use the repeater to make a tiled background transition like you're seeing right now. The repeater is a powerful tool within shape layers, and there are a number of uses for it. As always, you can save this as a preset and use it in future projects easily. Okay, let's create a new shape layer, add a group, and we'll call this group 1, master rectangle 1. And then we want to add another group inside of this, and we are going to name this rectangle 1. And inside of this group, let's add a rectangle, a stroke, and a fill. Now let's change this fill to like an orange, change the stroke. Let's copy the color of the fill, but then make it a little darker for the stroke. And let's increase this to 150. Let's increase our stroke size to 27. For now, we just want to animate the stroke. So let's hide this fill. We won't delete it. Let's just hide it. Go into our rectangle path. Let's set a keyframe at 0, and we'll make the size 0. Go forward about a second. Make this 150. We also want to animate our stroke width. So we're going to set a keyframe for 27, but we want to move this to about 15 frames. Let's go back to 0 and set the stroke width to 0. And up at a second, we will make that 0 as well. Let's highlight all of these keyframes and click F9 to make them bezier. And you have something like that. In our master rectangle, we're going to add a repeater. And this will repeat everything above it. So basically this rectangle here. You can see the repeater is already kind of doing some work. It adds 3 copies by default. We want to add 21 copies. And we want our row to go from left to right with our anchor point in the center. So it's a good idea to have these copies set at an odd number. So the midpoint is 10. So let's put negative 10. And we also want to offset these so they're not touching. And now we can go back into our source rectangle. Let's change this rotation to 45. Then we can go back into our repeater 1 position, and we want to move this over. They're just barely touching. And what we have so far is this. Go to our repeater 1, and let's control D. So we're going to duplicate repeater 1. For repeater 1, we have our position set at 194.0. Let's set this at 200.0. What we want to do is we want to do the opposite for repeater 2. So we want our X value to be 0 and our Y value to be 200. And there you go, we have this array. So the way we got that was repeater 1, X is 200, Y is 0. Repeater 2, X is 0, Y is 200. So we have that right there. To fill in the holes, let's duplicate this rectangle 1. And we want to include our fill with this. We want to make sure these edges are touching, but not necessarily overlapping. For repeater 1, let's go back into here. And I'm going to spread this out a little bit more, say 210. And then for repeater 2, we want to make sure this is 0, 210. So now to fill in the entire screen, Control D, the master rectangle. If we open up this, we're going to go to the transform properties for master rectangle 2. We want to move the layer over so it fills in all of the white space. So just like that, we don't want to leave any white space. Now you can hold on the control button and adjust your position. It moves it a lot more slowly. We have this. We want to kind of mess with these keyframes. What we want to do is, this is our second master rectangle group. Let's move this over to about 10 frames. For this animation of this first rectangle, we want this to be offset. So let's go to about 5 frames, grab this group here, move it over. So we have that kind of motion. And then the same thing for our second rectangle, page down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and move these over. So what we end up having is that. Kind of cool. You want your color, your fill, you want that to be the color that you're going to. So say, for example, if the background is supposed to be like a blue, you want to change this to like whatever blue you want. The stroke, I like to choose the same color as my fill, but then just kind of darken it. And you want to do that for both of these rectangles. You want your stroke of this, grab the eyedropper, choose the stroke from that. For the fill, you want that to be that blue. You can save this as a preset and bring it in instantaneously, and I'll show you how to do that. Save your rectangles, repeaters, and your transform properties. If you don't save your transform properties, the preset will bring up a default transform property setting. Go to animation, save animation preset. It's going to bring you back to your user presets. And as you can see, I have a lot of folders that I created in here. These are reflected in your After Effects project. So I want to go into transitions, and I'm going to call this repeater diamond background transition. Click save. We can go in here to our contents, and we just delete that. Go into your animation presets, user presets, scroll down to transitions, and you can find it here. Repeater diamond background transition, or you can go and just do a search. Like I would type in diamond and you see it right here. Now this preset does have keyframes, so it does matter where your playhead is, because wherever your playhead is where the first keyframes will be dropped. So you can either come back to the beginning, or if you don't want to, you can go anywhere on the layer and click I. It brings you back to the beginning. Let's drag this in and there we go. Again, you want to make sure whenever you save these, if you adjust the transform properties of one of these groups, you have to highlight transform as well. Otherwise, there's a default setting for transform properties. And that's how you create a tiled background using the repeater. The repeater is a powerful tool within Shape Layers. You can use a repeater to create patterns, transitions, and so much more. The more you experiment, the more comfortable you'll become using the repeater. I hope this helped you out. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything you'd like to see and if this episode was helpful. Thanks, everybody. See you next time.